there are some risk factors of high blood pressure. Let's show that to our viewers and take them one by one. Doctor, go.
Again, we talked about family history. In my case, my mom and dad had high blood pressure. I'm one of four boys, and what a surprise, all four of us have high blood pressure that need therapy. We're all doing well. The good news is that just because you have high blood pressure or a family history doesn't necessarily mean that you need to die prematurely as a result, because effective treatment that normalizes the blood pressure actually can increase life expectancy dramatically. But certainly if your mother and or father and or brothers or sisters have high blood pressure, you more than likely will develop it, and certainly need to be vigilant about checking it frequently. Age, gender, and race, as we get older, our risk for high blood pressure goes up. The systolic blood pressure goes up by about 10 points for every decade over 50. So if normal is 50 at 120 over 80, then when you're 60, the systolic pressure goes up to, on average, go up to 130, and by 70, 140, et cetera. Now, we used to believe that was it is a normal response to aging, but we now know that keeping those numbers below 130 over 80 at all times, even though as we get older, there is a natural tendency to increase systolic blood pressure, is extremely important. Kidney disease increases the risk of high blood pressure. Oftentimes you see the kidney specialists are the ones, in addition to cardiologists, who specialize in the treatment of high blood pressure. Again, sedentary lifestyle, lack of exercise, unhealthy diet, being overweight or obese are the lifestyle factors that if you do change, generally weight loss can lead to reductions in blood pressure. Though there are plenty of thin people who have high blood pressure and plenty of obese people who have normal blood pressure, the heavier that you are, the more likely your blood pressure will be higher. And certainly weight loss can have a dramatic effect on getting people to get off of medicine or reduce the amount of medicine they're on. And then, of course, the other factors of high cholesterol, high blood sugar, cigarette smoking, are the medical dashboard that we've already talked about, and things like sleep apnea and stress can also lead to high blood pressure.